Hello, everyone. G2 are coming up against NIP. Hopefully NIP can have a better time of things. To quote Get Right, I probably can't do it because you never know when we're on TV these days, but he said it was... well, he's not happy with how things went there. Let's say that.
Show me the tweet. Is it a tweet?
It is, yeah.
Is it a tweet?
I'm not going to scroll like right now, but...
Okay, I can find it maybe.
Freddie B is still playing for Freiburg. Freiburg has fever, so unfortunately, he won't be with us.
What kind of fever?
Send him well wishes.
Disco fever?
Don't know. Maybe it's Ebola fever.
That's not a good one to have.
We just went to... well, I don't know. All the travel these guys do, someone's got to have Ebola by this point.
I guess.
Ebola boys. Hopefully they
sounds
don't.
Sounds reasonable.
So the knife happens and two players disconnect. So that's interesting. Screaming Shocks, we've had enough.
I see his tweet now.
What does his tweet say, Dan?
It says he wasn't happy with how things went.
Is that what it said?
Yeah.
Is that word for word?
It's not verbatim, though.
No.
It's paraphrased.
Okay, so what do you expect? I mean, you're expecting a G2 win?
I think G2 will win.
Okay. Well, there it is. You heard it here first.
What do you expect besides being eaten by sharks?
Why do you do this to me, man? Do you know,
you might not get eaten, though. You might just get... They might just bite you and then pull you away. You might survive.
What if I actually die? Are you going to feel guilty?
No.
Okay, so here's the run boost we were talking about the other day. We saw quadruple stacks, but this one's the run boost. Not working out just yet, though. RPK will be traded one for one, and now it's time for NIP. They need to get the bomb onto the site and get out of vents. They can't stall, they can't stay here, because they're allowing the rotation to come in from the CTs. Exist lining up the grenades. There it goes, but Smith is still on the site. He's reloading, he's dead! Scream on the high ground now. This is working out for NIP for the time being, but they're tagged. They're heavily tagged. That's going to make life easier for G2.
Bomb is planted. The health is low, though, for NIP. The NIP players. In goes G2. Shocks. So fun to watch Shocks. What has he got for us? Gets a tag onto Forest. Problems here for NIP as these G2 players close the distance, and they now close the round. Very nicely done by a G2. And a good G2 start is a scary premonition for going into that second half, I think, because NIP, they have to get this done on the CT, on the T side. And again, they're playing with a stand-in. But it's okay because Forrest has changed his name. He's gone for alternating capitals. Therefore, he is now powered up, James. He's gone Super Saiyan. He's in the next stage.
Maybe
the next
he has
transformation.
Maybe he has a malfunctioning keyboard. Let's see what he can do with this AK. I love these buys. We have seen them recently. We have seen them as of late. As of late is a lovely phrase. Oh, no! Oh, no, Forrest! He's seen no one! That grenade is pixel perfect. That's a solid 55 HP done by Scream. And Forrest is the only man with armor.
It's like a pie in the face, isn't it? It's like a pie in the face. Maybe you don't know. Maybe you should ask Moses instead. Now, Forrest is even lower. 34 health on him. And the passive play from G2 to try to secure things. They eliminate exist by door. And now it is Forrest he's just going to go for it. Oh, he's dead. RPK lurking behind the box. Ah, oh, it's a bad look here for NIP.
It's a bad miss.
It's going to be tough now to get off to a good start in a timely manner, as G2 are going to have a good economy, and NIP are going to have a full save. They did save quite a bit of cash, actually, because they got the bomb down. So I am talking absolute rubbish, James. I'm talking rubbish.
Can't believe you've done this.
I can't believe I have done this. And now we've got the AKs in and a few smoke grenades as well. Will they go for a fast play, though, with like a fast set piece?
Only time will tell. Shox getting picked off on a solo A push, a main push, which NIP will be firmly in control of. That said, Smith's in the meantime has got a forward position towards B with the trusty MP9. But how further forward will he go? RPK around connector at the moment. Smith's getting a lot of information for his team, but he's going to run because he's having to go the long way around. Get right spotted, but how much can Body do? He's slowed him down a little bit. RPK picking off another kill. And now we've got Smith coming in from main. MP9 though. If he sees Forest, his range is going to suck. He needs exist. There he is! Opportunity now. I don't know if he saw Forest, but if he did, he can play the baiting game. Now everyone has the information.
The information.
The round. Words, Dan. Continue to be hard.
Do they confound you? Do they confuse you? Are you confuddled?
I am kabobulous. That's what I am.
You're bewildered, you're bemused.
I'm slightly kabobulous.
I love alliteration. Alliteration is lovely. Lovely. So in comes NIP with the Deagles, and will we see like a cold-esque play? No. Did you see that, James? The cold Deagle in mid on cash against NIP in Oakland. Did you see that?
Was it two shots?
He just like walks through a smoke and just like instantly caps two people with a Deagle. It was just unreal. It was unreal. Well, this is a pretty clear affair right now as well for G2. They clean up everybody. They lose RPK and that's it. Bad start, fast start for G2. Well, bad start for Ninjas, good and fast start for G2. And we get the big guns out from NIP Forest on the T side AWP as per usual. Let's see how this one works out for the NIP side. I mean, typically they've just been going for defaults and so on. We haven't seen anything too creative, and largely perhaps you could expect that because they are playing with a stand-in. It does limit them. Again, NIP are a team that do have a lot of highly technical stuff. Playing with stand-in must surely limit you.
Especially when the stand-in is not like a lurker.
Yeah, you right, know, exactly, yeah.
Like he can just do solo jobs on his own. That's not the case. And in fact, the lurker's been taken down in this round. What a horrible time for a player to be sick. Smith again going aggressive towards the B bomb site. Getting info for his team. This time he's got the AK, so he can just hold this position. This position is really good because you can hold that angle exactly and see people coming out of vents as well, which means that you need far less players towards that area. Trades coming in for both sides, so Slimane advantage. Scream spotted though, and Forest is just holding angles in the meantime. Exists running distraction, but Smith is coming to save Scream, but will he come fast enough? There it is, there's a kill, but Forrest may, he's got bigger problems now as well. And Shoxi will take him down as NIP are desperately trying to reposition. So it's all falling apart at the moment. Shoxi will put an end to this round. So many small things happening at the same time. And then it's G2. Bloody hell. It's G2 with five rounds.
Bloody hell.
Get Right hasn't got any kill just yet, but then his team haven't got much done either. Freddy B, funnily enough, has got four kills. Everybody else is on one, save for Get Right, who's on nil.
So fast play into A. We've got Body and Shox there. It's going to be quite fun, actually, for the position that Shox is in. You can see at quad, he's going to get quite some damage done. Two players taken down. Looking to find an additional one coming up short, looking for the split because middle's been given up, but it's not to be. Shox is going to come back straight into that angle, onto the A main area, pick himself up one more. He has just decimated, single-handedly decimated NIP.
Shox is amazing, man. He is amazing. Like, every time. He's always amazing.
Would you marry Shox?
No.
Okay.
I wouldn't marry Shox, but he's amazing.
Why not?
Well, I'm not gay for one.
Oh, okay.
So that's a problem. And I'm not in love with him either. So, I mean, I think that's enough criteria, basically.
Fair enough. You make a logical argument. Sometimes you just gotta ask the question. No such thing as stupid questions, any stupid answers I've heard. Anyway, here comes the push onto the B-bomb site for NIP, get something done with the Tech-9s. Smith's just spraying.
Spraying and praying. Remember the days of spray and pray?
Yep.
Spray and pray. Sometimes it's what you gotta do.
I think I first heard someone say that in like the year 2000. When I was playing. Or maybe a little bit later than that. But it was in very, very early CS days for me. Back, I was playing Aztec. I remember when I saw someone say it, and it was in Aztec. I was under the bridge in the water. And I killed someone. They were like, "Oh, you spray and pray." Like, "Why, yes, I did, and you died."
Lovely two-man push through Squeaky Door from the CTs. Early advantages. Shortly lived as Smith gets picked off. Body's in trouble as well. Down to 13 HP on the A site. Got to be careful. Got to be afraid of Molotovs from a team with the prowess of NIP. But again, everything, the pace will be slowed down after those initial offerings. RPK in a forward position towards the B bomb site, just sitting behind the box for now. We'll have to see if he goes for a push later on. Exist and Freddy B have crept into the middle area behind the wall of smokes. But nobody is there to engage them.
It's an interesting spot to find yourself in for NIP because they have middle now and the time is kind of ticking away. And they want to split sort of this A play, but I'm not convinced because of Shox sitting on quad with the AWP. They must know that Shox, of course, in the last round he's playing this position. He killed them from that position. What do they have to deal with Shox? Because that's what you have to ask yourself in this situation. That's what you have to do in this situation. Because if you just go for the raw peek like that, you know Shox is going to be playing around quad. This is a really big problem. And he's going to sit in the fire. They do actually get the kill on him, but the boost position, oh, he doesn't get anything actually. That is very underwhelming as to what you'd usually expect from that position. And that's a well done by NIP, but still, there's a chance here for the G2 side.
RPK gets a pick off on the flank, and now they know where he is. Now they know he's the last man. No grenades on NIP, just guns to wield. RPK's got some Molotovs and so on. If he can get a 1v1, we'll see what he can do. Oh, straight in the face! Freddy B may fear the peak, and RPK is going for the next one. But Forrest is ready for the angle, and RPK two places to look scared of his six. That will give the round to NIP. Good effort, though. Those post-plant smokes between the wall and that box as well are so good for the terrorist side. Something that TSM actually used quite well, and that was noticeable on their road to improvement, which soon went off track. Back to these two teams, though. G2 with money in the bank, Smiths with an auto sniper, and they'll still be good for another buy should this go bad for them, the G2 side. Opportunity knocks to reset the economy. Smiths getting a bit cheeky. Nothing doing just yet though, and I don't think he's played his hand with that auto sniper. He hasn't fired a single bullet. They are unawares.
So all quiet here. For the moment, we get a peek from RPK though, and that's going to initiate things. Gets the kill, and I mean, the thing is that there's no information there, it's just basically a frag. Because there's over a minute left to play within the round, so NIP can still do a myriad of things. There's a myriad of options. Does Get Right check this position? Does Scream reveal himself? It is a yes to both of those questions. I think Get Right must have heard the scope there. Surely he heard the scope. Maybe he didn't. I heard the scope. Now he's seen Shoxi though, but Shoxi doesn't take the shot. So, having taken 50 damage, he's going to get out of there. And the push comes in to B here. NIP look very good to take this. Just Smith here. Smith could do so much damage from this position though. There is a Molotov, however.
Shoxi's already rotated into position before the full push has come in. Smith gets taken down immediately. Shox holding angles, waiting for players to move to the site. There's the first one to exist. Can he go for the re-peek though? Smartly, not going to overextend when people will be holding angles. He'll just focus on the site. He can run distraction now as Body looks for something. Did he spot a barrel from Forrest? He did it! And that is leaving Forrest, Shox alone. Well, he may give this one up. Or will he? I think he was suggesting he was abandoning ship, maybe inviting Nip to hunt after him. But it might be about hiding in plain sight, I don't know. What Shox might be up to here.
We saw him do this yesterday, actually, where he likes to hang around and basically threaten the defuse, just to keep players on the site and then get additional kills. Because he seems so confident that he can escape as well. Last time he did this, he actually forced someone to kind of chase him in paranoia, and he actually got an extra kill out of it. The exact same play, in fact, from Shox in this exact same position. So, but last time he did get a frag out of it. So I love that from him. He tries to get all the edges he can because he's so confident.
He is aware of his ability. Pit and Exist still on one kill apiece at the moment. They're going to need to turn up if NIP are to continue their winning ways. 5-round deficit at the moment. Good half for G2 so far. And again, they lose that round, but they're back on the bye, and they've still got more money in the bank as their loss bonus starts to creep upwards. Could see a boost towards mid at some point. Oh, Exist just walking in and out of Shox's crosshair. Has no idea, though. Ooh, Exist may have seen Shox. Think he's looking for the kill now. Oh, God. That was so close so many times. Shox down to 35 HP. Exist still untouched. Pop Flash is coming in, but there's no commitment here from the T's. There is crossfire for G2, but that could end up shooting themselves in that situation. And now they will back off. Lots of utility spent in the middle area. Lovely angles from Exist, almost finishing off RPK as well. Now you've got RPK and Shox heavily tagged, but still no frags for either side.
So everyone's getting tagged up slowly but surely. 50 seconds left, and bodies will start to fall as we start to see the push coming in towards that B-bomb site. Or well, we should at least, I think, here. We see the push coming from Smith. Takes down Get Right, important frag. Ooh, the jump across. Didn't realize that there was more players where that came from. Gets caught by Forrest. That's the problem. RPK's stuck on the bomb site now. He's left to hold this with 11 HP. Scream comes in for support up top, but it's not the best position in the world to work from. So it's going to be difficult to see whether or not can actually get any frags here. Oh, the flashes come in, the teammates come in. And looks like they should be safe here. 10 seconds, there's surely no time to do this. Scream does a hell of a job. And four seconds, Shoxi gets the frag. And that's the round.
That's crazy. Unfortunately, based on what was going on, NIP moving too slow to the site. The bomb falls almost out of the site once Freddy B gets picked as well, because G2 had three men on the rotation. There were smokes down lower and upper B, so they couldn't help RPK. They were in no position to help. But by the time those smokes started disappearing, they still had time to come in for those frags. And now that leaves NIP with two AKs, bunch of pistols, bunch of utility as well, looking for an execute towards the A site. And again, the team just not killing. Just not getting the frags. Shoxi and body over towards A. Most of NIP just hanging out around main, around the T warehouse at the moment. Get Right makes his way towards mid. But he's not crossing it just yet. He's got a Tech 9, so we need to get closer. Pit is lining up a smoke grenade for quad. It's actually difficult to open a door sometimes from that position. But normally you line up the grenades at the top of the arrow and it bounces a smoke out into quad.
So it's push time. Shox in a position to make highlights. AWP in hand by quad as the push hits the site. And Shox will hit players with his AWP, as will Scream with his M4. So looking quite good here. Oh my god, what is going on? Why did that take so long to bloom? This is chaos here at the back of the bomb site. Shox still alive though, and he's got support. Get Right, the only man standing for NIP. And he is going to only be on a Tech 9 as well. I say only a Tech 9, but at these distances can be quite brutal. You can see the Tech 9 rattling away there. Not able to get the frag though. Do wonder what happened at the quad. We're going to see Scream and Shox both panic smoking it. And they both dropped smokes in and neither smoke bloomed. That seemed really weird.
Yeah, since they've made changes to the smokes and Molotov, sometimes the smoke grenade just bounces through fire before it goes off. I don't know if that's by design or what, but it can be quite the pain for whoever is dropping the smoke. Especially based on what you're used to. If it takes a while to bloom, then puts your calculations off. Sometimes it can delay putting the fire out as well, even when it blooms, it's mad. It's very odd indeed. NIP on pistols now, dominating half so far from G2, and it looks to continue here. Despite one player being picked off, Get Right manages to pick up a rifle. There's potential for a flank now towards B-split, or Get Right can just threaten it, and that can be a problem in itself. But NIP still not too close to either site, heading towards A at the moment. Body is there, and he's the only one there.
He's got stickers on his forehead as well. Stickers on his forehead. Like he's playing some kind of party game. But NIP are the ones looking to have a party on that A-bomb site. Here they go. Pit gets the frag. RPK, he's got to tap players down, but there's not much to do it with. It's going to be just Smith left now against three. It's very doable considering that no player has Kevlar. Smith can just get one-on-ones. He can absolutely win this. But he's against some very classy players. So here he goes. Smith's looking for that first committed peek, but they're just toying with him. They're never wanting to really take the engagement here. Oh, that kill is going to actually send Smith forwards now to go for the play. Flashbang to the corner. One player peeks out again. Pytus for the delay. Oh, wow, just offering himself up to Smith, but Smith is a little bit too far away to get the defuse in. Unfortunate.
Yeah, I think he had given up on it and was just making sure that nobody left the site alive. Pit with four deagle kills in that round. All over the map as well. He's everywhere with that deagle. Where was the last one? Just peppering, getting that final chunk of damage. 9-3 for G2. Is there any way back into this half for NIP at this point? That's the question. Shoxy going for a push towards B with RPK and Smith's in tow. This is a very fast push indeed. And there'll be a two-man rotation. They'll leave Smith in a forward position. That's going to be a nasty surprise, but NIP will soon find out about this flank. There goes Get Right. Now Smith will have to back off, surely, because they're going to come looking for him.
Yeah.
He could, if he backs off, he could be towards T-spawn as well, as opposed to just back towards B.
I mean, I feel like you just want him to hold an off angle here. Just hold a deep off angle, force them to commit something to take you down, whilst your teammates can do something on the rest of the map, because your threat of being there and attracting attention is bigger than you trying to take a fight and winning a one-on-one, I think, in many cases. Because now, NIP, there are a couple frags across the map here, but they have that open channel back to B. That said, we've got RPK there with the FAMAS. He's in an off-angle as well, and he's going to take the frag on to Forest, and it's just going to be Pits left. So that push, that really pushed G2 ahead in this round, and they've managed to come out into a 3-1 advantage now. When all is said and done, Pit understands there's a flank coming, but he's going to take one straight to the face. 10-3, the score, as G2 are looking good. Shox is going to be happier with today so far, I think. But again, NIP with a stand-in, that is always going to be sad.
Second last round, 2K per person in the bank, and they're going to have to eco RNIP. G2's money was low, and it still is low in the hole, but they're unlikely to have much problems in terms of finance in this particular round. Get Right, I think they know he's there. He's got 4 HP. I don't know if there are any Molotovs towards the B bomb site. No, there aren't, actually. So he can stand there for a while. Don't think G2 will be too committed to hunting that frag. Get Right will eventually have to serve himself up, and indeed he does. Forest, last man standing, last man to fall. Onwards and upwards, at least for G2 scoreboard.
So where do NIP go with this one? They got really unlucky in the last round, because in a lot of rounds they run defaults. They will catch that push, and maybe they'll go one for one and kind of block the push so early on that the G2 would have to abandon it. And they'll be happy. They would be happy maybe to have the one-on-one, but or the one-for-one. But still, we have a situation there where NIP went with a fast play into mid and that left them with no one there. So that's not going to often happen. We see a similar thing this round, though. A very committed movement towards A, very fast movement towards A. Perhaps just favoring keeping things very simple, having the stand-in as well. Just trying to get that last round on the board, but Shox's position is great. Oh!
I think I know why that happens. Potentially, body caught with a nade in his hand. Oh, man, that is a shutdown. Two B players rotating towards A now. And there's some time for NIP to get into those post-plant positions. They know RPK and Smith are the B players. There goes RPK. Smith on a 1v4. He has a lot to do. and can barely see anything with all these smokes down. And there's a headshot from out of nowhere. After Shoxi was boosted up on the roof, he jumped. I don't know if it was deliberate because he had an accident with his mouse the other day where he jumped by accident and got picked off. But he was on the roof already. He was just crouching and he jumped. And if that made a sound, then it would have been a clue for Exist, or maybe he just looked for it, one or the other. Anyway, that round is colossal for NIP. Having four rounds over three is huge. But, of course, the pistol is just as huge, if not huge, huger, more huge. Oh, God. Shoxi, the P250. He won't be the raid boss, but, again, the P250 and grenades. P250 has almost double the range for one shot versus a Glock in a pistol round because there are no helmets. Let's go.
Indeed. I'll call you a wordsmith, but you're more of a word pawn shop or something. Some people take their used words and you pawn them off.
Word butcher,
something like that, to that effect. Ooh, Shoxi's going to spot one coming in the back. He will allow him to pass for now. But there is an expiry date on Get Rights.
Oh, the one tap.
He's soon to... Oh,
oh my God,
the flick.
Shox.
So easy frags there for Shox. And it's great to see that we've got Shox on that P250 as well. Definitely does good work with it. And Freddie B. Forrest coming in for the defuse. I don't know how good their chances are here. I think their chances are pretty bad, especially with Shox still alive. Three frags for him in this round. And an easy 12-4 for a G2. What a start.
His aim is just so good. How can I have the same? How? Tell me. Man. How can you not be excited just watching Shox? It's mental. 8 round leads. And I mean, that's before you even get to Forest. Like, there's more than one player on this server who is absolutely insane to watch, but Shox definitely having better time at the moment. Just Freddie B with Kevlar in this round. NIP around $800 each. Some money has been left in the hole. G2 focusing on the B bomb site. The Molotovs are coming out. This should be a fast anti-eco round.
Yeah, one would expect that. Got Pit though with that Deagle. He's been doing good work with it previously, so let's see what he can do. He's going to push through the smoke. Or just sit in the smoke. Oh, there it is. There's the push. Hard to see what's actually going on. But largely speaking, G2 have run an exemplary anti-eco round. And they have the bomb site, the bomb sticking away. And even though NIP can get a couple kills here, but then winning the round is very, very difficult to do considering that bomb sticking away and they got no kit. So the job's been done here by G2. NIP might steal away this MAC-10 though. That's nice, I guess. Oh, Exist could get kills with the MAC-10. This is a great position to be in. Oh my God. Oh, that would have been so nice to get two headshots there. Another, like, follow-up headshots would be great, but no, not to be. 13-4 though, and G2 are 3 away from taking cash against the Ninjas.
Yeah, this is a strong start from G2. Will it lead to a solid finish? Again, this is the pick of G2. Nuke, the pick of NIP. And again, that might be very difficult with Freiburg unable to play due to illness. But first, we'll see how this map will conclude. NIP on the eco. Little to offer in this round. It may be a slaughter. G2 went quick towards A. Now they'll eventually go towards B. No need to be fast. 5 versus 3, though, is good. And now the Molotovs will start raining in. Grenades for days. This is what we like to see. One player to be discovered on the site. For those of you at home, never run onto a bomb site that has not been checked with the bomb in your hands. It is wholly unnecessary. Run with your gun. Run with your gun.
So one last chance. I think there's a Biggie Small song that is entitled One Last Chance, I think. Or no, it's One More Chance, isn't it? This is not like that, but it is. There's one last chance here for Ninjas in Pajamas with these rifles of theirs. And we've got RPK pushing the smoke. Well, he's a distant memory now. They shall have to move on. They shall have to forget. As he lies there. having done more or less nothing actually in this round for the G2 side, but perhaps that can be changed by the likes of Smiths and Scream, who are in the vicinity. However, G2, oh wow, Shox loves to do this, by the way. This is such a Shox kind of move, you know, moving into these forward positions amongst the smoke. And you can see now Body on the minimap, he's moving in middle as well. Get Right might actually spot that at some point. He's playing very passive and connected. There's no one spotting mid at all for NIP just yet. Very passive setup.
Shox waiting for a rotation, waiting for a surprise pick. And he's got Body moving up short at the same time. Not sure if he made a sound jumping off that position, but that allows him to get much more forward. Something less to worry about now. Default comes in and taken down. That's a clear A bomb site. Freddy B and Forrest, they have opportunity. We've got a flank coming in, which Shox may not expect. But Smiths will clean that up, leaving Freddy B to do what he can for NIP, the stand-in. Not much you can do against a crab-walking Shox, though. 15-4, a 9-round lead and match point for G2.
That was a really cool play by Body. He basically allowed for that round to be opened up. Obviously, Shox's ability to make a play was hinged on Body being able to do something. And Body got two kills just walking up in middle alone, in short alone. Great stuff from Body.
Double scout, triple UMP. That is the order. Oh, okay. And Get Right's not going to stop. I don't think he's in T Warehouse. And but the T's are charging straight back. Freddy Bean exists. Scout and UMP versus four G2 players, and G2 may be able to dispose of the fallen AK or use it as bait. Freddy B here, Shoxy running around. That's going to be a free kill for him, but the bomb is towards B. So it exists, but he only has a scout to offer these people. And now they start to move in. Almost perfect time on a smoke grenade there. Exists left to take pot shots. Pot flashing coming in as well. He's going to push for the smoke with the scout. He's going for the hero play of all hero plays. Oh, he had a chance. And now Freddy B has little. Another smoke kill. Another day, another dollar. RPK playing off angles. He may have been spotted. It seems that he must have been.
Oh, poor Freddy B left alone in the 1-on-3. He did his best, but it wasn't enough. And now NIP.
I remember
are in the dust.
I remember what I had forgotten on the previous cache now. You saw the position that RPK was just in, next to the slope. On the CT defense of around, Dupree was in that position. And there's a series of videos of Shox actually on YouTube.
They're awesome.
Where he talks about maps and how he approaches positions and maps and so on. And one thing he talks about is playing off angles on cache like those two sides next to the ramp where people are never going to pre-fire you, that can give you the extra advantage to take a pick even if you're completely exposed, essentially, or kind of half exposed. So that's what I wanted to say earlier, and now I can rest in peace.
Took you two maps.
Yeah.
I think.
It's a bad day for NIP. I needed a trigger. That's what I needed. I got my trigger. Bad day for NIP, dominating map there for G2. And is there anything you'd like to say about
that? No. Time for a break, and then we've got some analysis with Mr. Halvor.
It's time now, my brother.